Hi everyone, we have quite a snappy dispatch video this week and it relates to the contract of employment and specifically what happens where a contract is not provided until perhaps a few months into the employment relationship. I've come across some businesses in the past who treat a probationary period as something which is pre-employment. That's not correct. A contract is formed at the point at which an employee accepts an offer, and a contract does not have to be written down. Ultimately, if it's not on paper anywhere, it would be a job of the tribunal ultimately to construct those terms from the intention and actions of the parties. But say we have an employee who was provided with an offer letter, they accepted, they start on day one, and after 3 months, they are provided with a contract of employment. It can give rise to a few difficulties. Firstly, there is a breach of the obligation to provide a contract on day one, which came into force on the 6th of April 2020. Whilst there is no direct remedy other than asking for a declaration of terms from the tribunal, if an employee who has another employment tribunal claim and is still not being provided with a contract, they can make an additional claim for an award of 2 or 4 weeks' pay for a failure to provide certain employment particulars. But the wider issues tend to relate to actually constructing the terms and trying to impose new terms on the employee. So if you consider notice periods, for example, there are statutory minimum periods in the Employment Rights Act, which is essentially a week from the employee and 1 week from the employer for every year of service, up to a maximum of 12 weeks. If the employer tries to provide a contract after a few months, which imposes new terms on the employee, and that contract remains unsigned, there's a lot of uncertainty about what actually applies on termination of employment, and the employer may find it difficult to hold the employee to a different notice period than is contained in the Employment Rights Act. One of the other issues to come across is post-termination restrictions. So at the start of employment, if an employee is given a contract which contains certain restrictive covenants after employment, and they sign up to the contract, agreeing to become employed, that is generally adequate consideration for putting those covenants into place. Once the employment relationship started, if the employer wants to start adding new obligations, so introduces restrictive covenants after 3 months for the first time, there is an argument that additional consideration should have to be provided in order for the employee to be bound by those restrictions. Another issue is if the contract remains unsigned. If that happens, there is no evidence that the employee has given express agreement to the restrictions, and it will be very difficult to enforce after employment without a signature on the document. So in essence, get your house in order at the start of employment. When you're making that offer, ideally the offer letter would be subject to contract, the contract would be enclosed with that offer letter, and the employee signs agreeing to become employed based on the terms of the contract alone. If you do need any further support on this issue or anything employment law generally, please do get in touch. Visit the website chadwicklawrence.co.uk or email employmenthub@chadlaw.co.uk. Thank you.